So it's a mass memorial. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us prepare ourselves to offer these sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners to repentance, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of God to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your light, your right hand, O Lord, we pray, encompass your family with the perpetual help, so that defended from all wickedness by the resurrection of your only begotten Son, we may make our way by means of your heavenly gifts. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. The first reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. There was an attempt in Iconia by both the Gentiles and the Jews, together with their leaders, to attack and stone Paul and Barnabas. They realized it and fled to Iconia, cities of Lystra and Derbe, and to the surrounding countryside, where they continued to proclaim the good news. At Lystra, there was a crippled man, lame from birth, who had never walked. He listened to Paul speaking. He looked intently at him, so that he had the faith to be healed, and called out in a loud voice, "Stand up straight on your feet." He jumped up and began to walk about. When the crowd saw what Paul had done, they cried out in Iconia, "The gods have come down to us in human form." They called Barnabas, Zeus, and Paul, Hermes. And the priest of Zeus, because he was the chief speaker. And the priest of Zeus, whose temple was at the entrance of the city, brought oxen and garlands gates. For together with the people intended to offer sacrifice, the apostles Barnabas and Paul tore their garments when they heard this and rushed out into the crowd shouting, "Men, why are you doing this? We are of the same nature as you, human beings. We proclaim to you good news that you should turn from these idols to the living God, who made heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in them. In past generations, he allowed all Gentiles to go their own ways, yet in bestowing in goodness, he did not leave them without witness. He gave you rain from heaven and fruitful seasons, and filled you with nourishment and gladness for your hearts." Even with these words, the scribe restrained the crowds from offering sacrifice to them. The word of the Lord. Not us, O Lord, but your name give glory. Not us, O Lord, but your name give glory. Not us, O Lord, not us, but your name give glory because of your mercy, because of your truth. Why should the pagans say, "Where is their God?" Not us, O Lord, but your name give glory. Our God is in heaven. Whatever he wills, he does. Their idols are silver and gold, their handwork men. Not us, O Lord, but your name give glory. May you be blessed by the Lord who made heaven and earth. Heaven is the heaven of the Lord, but the earth he has given to children of men. Not us, O Lord, but your name give glory. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. The Holy Spirit will teach you everything. I remind you of all I told you. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O
Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. Whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." Judas, not the Iscariot, said to him, "Master, then what happened that you will reveal yourself to us and not to the world?" Jesus answered and said to him, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you, the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you everything and remind you all that I told you. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, we have been meditating on the virtue of faith. We have three virtues, Christian virtues. We can call them cardinal virtues: faith, hope, and love. So the condition we have been hearing of becoming a disciple of Jesus Christ, it was have faith in him, believe in him, then you are baptized, you become his disciples. And now he's coming with another one, the virtue of love, charity. If you love me, you have to keep my commandments. And as you know, Jews had many rules, many commandments. They were like 6, 13. And when Jesus came, reduced them to 10 commandments of God. And he said, the major commandment is the commandment of love. Love of God and love of neighbor. And this is what Barnabas and Paul are trying to witness to these communities of Iconia, Lystra, and Derbe. As Paul and Barnabas, they are preaching the risen Lord, there is this crippled man who is just listening at Paul. And when Paul looks at him, he's able to see that this man has faith. Loving him, he told him, stand up. And this man stood up, and everybody was astonished with this act. And we hear from that, people began now to worship, to adore those of Paul and Barnabas. But Paul and Barnabas, they say, no, we are not gods. We are just like you. Let us give praise to God, the Almighty. Let us give praise to Jesus Christ. Yes, it's because of love they saw from these disciples of Jesus Christ. What they did to this man, their faith came back. And we too, we are invited to express this love of God. To God and to our neighbors. Yes, we do talk of love. In Spanish, they speak of te amo. I love you, te amo. Am I right? Yeah, I love you. But love has to be expressed in not only in words, but also in deeds. Friend in need is a friend indeed. So this we have to express it. To express our love to God, to our neighbors. Yesterday, I wanted to go outside and expose myself because there was a little bit of sunshine. When I went out, I found there was a little bit of wind and what. I came back immediately. And I told the Father, I went outside there, but it's very cold. Maybe I could get a sweater or a jacket. Just expressing like that. And today in the morning when I opened my door, I found already there's a sweater there. So I say, oh, this is really a sign of love. Because Jesus said, the criteria is, I was sick, you came to visit me. I was in the prison, you came to visit me. I was hungry, gave me food. I was naked, you clothed me. I had no shelter, you sheltered me. Of course, some said, when did we see you? And we didn't do that. Whatever you did to the least of my brothers, you did to me. So let us not expect Jesus to come unto us, then we give him what we want to give him. Let us see our neighbors, some strangers, how are we treating them? For sure, from the bottom of my heart, I am a visiting priest. The way Father has been treating me, it is incredible. And I give praise to God. And I pray, Father, that God may continue blessing you abundantly. Yes. I have never failed to have something to eat, something to drink, to put on. And all this, I think, it is because you too, as the parishioners, you have been helping him. You have been charitable to him. That's why he's able also to reflect this to whoever comes into this rectory. I am not adoring the Father, I am not adoring the sweater he gave me. I'm just giving praise to who? To God. I'm giving praise to God through him for what he has done to me. So let us continue, my brothers, living this commandment of love, especially in this critical moment when everybody needs someone to say to him or to her, courage, my brother, courage, my sister. God loves us. We have hope in him. We have faith in him. We bring our needs before our Almighty God with the confidence that our prayers will be heard and answered, that our church leaders may be confirmed by Christ evermore into his image in their preaching of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord that leaders of nations and the people may be guided by the generous and compassionate hand of God in all they do. Let us pray to the Lord. Amen. That all who are living without religious freedom may be filled with courage through the grace of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord. Amen. That those in this faith community may be drawn closer to the Lord in his fullness. Through the grace of the sacraments, let us pray to the Lord. That those who have died, especially the mothers we remember in this month of May and in this novena, may know the glory of God and rest in eternal peace at his side. Let us pray to the Lord. And for our own special petitions, let us pray to the Lord. Generous and merciful God, we ask that you listen to the prayers we have placed before you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceased to offer himself to us, but defends us and ever plead our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with the paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give you praise, Father, most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed the man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, he did not abandon him to the dominion of death. For you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and time again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father, most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature and all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us. He sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruit for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of your Lord Jesus Christ. For the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father, most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end, and while they were at his supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of your redemption, remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory.
Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heaven inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with your apostles and saints in your kingdom, there with the whole creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth and in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await for the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
O sacrament most holy,
O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanksgiving
be every moment thine.
O sacrament most holy,
O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy,
O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
Prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you have already come, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life, in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go forth, Master's end.
Thanks be to God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be.
Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, we believe that you are here present as true God and true man. We raise our minds to your divine heart, to adore you, to praise you, and to thank you. We humbly ask pardon for all our sins and the sins of all humankind. Together we pray for the intentions of your sacred heart. O Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Apostles of Jesus, pray for us. All you martyrs, pray for us. And all you saints, pray for us.